Fit Intent Nation, it is day 58 of the Fit Intent Challenge, and I'm going to send you your new numbers tonight. I will send you new numbers tonight, and I will get your results to you from your in-body shortly here, okay? I'm hoping tonight I will get them to you, but it may not happen tonight, okay? So, and I'm still waiting on a few of you for your scans. I don't know where you are, but you should come in for your scan. You paid for it. Come in, get your scan, find out where you are. And, continue. You got to continue. You should continue. You know you want to continue. All right. Let's get right into some questions here. Okay, listen, I'm going to leave off from where I did yesterday. This person says, weekly exercise schedule. Okay, Sunday hockey, Monday, Fit Intent lower body, Tuesday night, boot camp with some lower body, Wednesday morning, extreme boot camp with some lower body focus, Thursday, sore muscles and lower back, no exercise, Friday, hockey and less sore, Saturday, Fit Intent, hopefully upper body focus, then 10 intervals at pace. All right, so I think you may have made a mistake. I think Tuesday was upper body, so I don't know where you're getting lower body from. That's possible in the boot camp portion of it that, there was some stuff where you were, using your legs. So, but the actual weight training component of it was upper body. Remember, don't get deadlifts confused with lower body, okay? Yeah, there is some hamstring and some glute activation there for sure. But for the most part, it's a back movement, okay? It's an upper body movement. I deadlift for my back. Unless I'm doing stiff leg deadlifts, it's a little bit different. That's gonna be more hamstring. But definitely traditional deadlifts, that is more back, okay? Lots of back in that. So that might be where you're getting confused. This person says also I had forgotten about glucosamine and MSM until you mentioned it in one of your videos. I used to take it when I was marathon training. I take it 2 to 3 times a day now. Yeah, I take it 3 times a day, and man, it makes a huge difference on my joints. To be honest with you, I took fixation and I took the glucosamine and MSM at the same time. So the glucosamine MSM was from Costco, and then right around the same time I started taking fixation, which isn't the best thing. You should just try one thing, especially when you have two products that are basically doing the same thing. But the fixation and the glucosamine MSM product that I have, they both have MSM actually. And then the fixation's got a bunch of other ingredients in there that the glucosamine MSM product doesn't. Anyways, taking these two things, I honestly can tell you my joints, in particular my right knee, like huge difference. And I think honestly overall bodily inflammation is down, because my lower back feels better. I have spondylitis in my lower back. I've had that my whole life. My hip feels better, my knee feels better. Everything generally feels a lot better, and it's not my mind, because I don't think it's in my mind, at least, because I certainly wasn't really expecting it to do anything. So anyways, if you guys have poor joints, and I know I mentioned this before, try the fixation product. I was so happy with it, I ordered a bunch of it. So I've got a bunch of it. If you want, let me know and I can get it to you, okay? This person also says, Famous Foods is a good place to buy meat. Okay, thank you. I will check them out. All right, let's just see what the next message into me here is. Is it long? Okay, I'll wait for this one till tomorrow. Okay, so I want to talk about, I don't really have a food of the day today, although I could have brought a food of the day in today, but you know, I talked about these bars, and of course I've talked about broccoli and other fibrous foods, like, well, I haven't talked about beans, but beans are obviously fiber. Apples, a lot of cruciferous vegetables have fiber in them. But I never talked about how to calculate fiber. At least I don't think I did, right? So I mentioned to you guys that there's soluble and there's insoluble fiber, and that the soluble fiber is really the only one that counts against your energy intake. And really, it's like it depends on the type of insoluble fiber, because there's different insoluble fibers that have different caloric amounts, but on average, it's about 2 calories per gram. Anyways, here's my point. I'm just gonna make this easy for you. You guys don't have to count your fiber going forward. You can leave your fiber out. Okay, so if I say you can have 100 grams of carbs per day, and let's say in your carb count you're having, I don't know, 40 grams of fiber. Okay, so you get your 100 grams of carbs, and in there you've got 40 grams of fiber. You can remove those 40 grams of fiber and put some non-fiber carbs in there. Okay, because those carbs, generally speaking, especially insoluble is gonna go right through you. It's not really going to have an impact on you, okay? It's only really the soluble that will, and even that, it's a very small impact, okay? About 50% of what a normal gram of carb has, okay? I raised this bar up because you guys probably know that these are very high in fiber. I do like these for that reason. Of course, it's not insoluble fiber, it's soluble fiber. He's got 14 grams, and I think I told you guys about the Quest bars. They've got, I think, 17 or 18 grams of pure soluble fiber in there, okay? But good bars to have, especially as your carbs get lower, because your carbs are gonna get lower. Okay. Message of the day. Yeah, I'm making these videos shorter. I vow to do this, and I'm gonna do it. Doesn't happen overnight sometimes, though. Listen, it's great when things are high, and it sucks when things are low. But we can't ride off of these things, okay? We can't always ride off these things. We have to have the courage to keep going forward. We have to have the courage to keep going forward. We have to kind of put our emotions aside and always just stick to the plan and keep going forward. And I say that because, dieting is a very emotionally based thing, right? We look at the scale, we look at ourselves in the mirror. Food is often an outlet for when we're not feeling good. It's often one of the first things that's gonna go when we are upset, right? So, this is where I'm gonna tell you guys, you have to really focus, and you gotta really have the courage to stay the course, right? So it's the courage to continue the course of action that counts more than anything, right? You're gonna have ups, you're gonna have downs. Of course, it's always easy to or it's always easier to do things that we want to do, or the things that we, not things we want to do, the things that we should do when things are going good. It's way harder when things are going bad, or we're having a bad day, or whatever, right? So basically, I'm gonna say it again, it sucks when things are, or it's great when things are high, it sucks when things are low, but it takes a courage to continue that counts, right? So you gotta have that courage to continue the process of this journey, right? Okay. Not bad. 8 minutes here, you guys. 8 minutes. 14 days left, 15 days left, maybe you got 16 days left. Let's give it everything we got, right? Submit, commit, you guys. Four workouts now. I'm gonna ask you guys to do 4 weight training workouts per week. You can do this. Four weight training workouts per week. Yeah, I'm adding in an extra one, okay? You don't have to, but if you're gonna do it now, right? We're near the end, right? So we're on a sprint. Okay? 20% to go. I'll talk to y'all soon, and have a wonderful Sunday. See you guys.